Happy New Year to one and all. Let's go through the week that went by and keep ourselves updated with what's happening in different parts of the country. Please note that this video is being made keeping in mind not just students who will be appearing for various competitive examinations, but also for the general public who do not have time to read the newspaper on a daily basis. We have tried to summarize the whole week for you. Let's begin with the instant triple talaq bill. The bill has been in news for quite some time now and was presented in the Rajya Sabha after being cleared by the Lok Sabha. The bill opposes the instant talaq system of uttering the word talaq thrice, also called as talaq-e-biddat. It recognizes the utterance of the word thrice as a non-bailable offence. However, the Rajya Sabha has suggested some more corrections to the bill and suggested that a high-level committee be formed to view the bill and will now be taken up in the next budget session. Approval of new proposal for H-1B visa could send more than 500,000 Indian techies back home. If the proposal by Trump administration of not extending H-1B gets implemented, more than 500,000 of India's skilled workforce would have to return home. The new proposal is introduced to prevent the misuse and abuse of H-1B visas, which is aligned to the president's Buy American, Hire American campaign that will lead towards protecting local jobs for Americans. The third is Muslim women can now go for Hajj without a male guardian. Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Sunday said his government had removed a discriminatory practice where Muslim women were allowed to travel for Hajj only in the company of a mahram or a male guardian. He expressed regret that such injustice was being rendered to Muslim women for the past 70 years in an independent India. The government has been constantly working on empowering women from all backgrounds, irrespective of their religion or caste. The fourth news is that Trump, citing Pakistan as a safe haven for terrorists, freezes aid. The decision, which could affect as much as $1.3 billion in annual aid, came 3 days after President Trump complained on Twitter that Pakistan had given us nothing but lies and deceit, and accused it of providing a safe haven to the terrorists we hunt in Afghanistan. The US has said that it is suspending at least $900 million in security assistance to Pakistan until Islamabad acts against the Afghan Taliban and Haqqani network militants. Now that's a very strong move from the US president. Let's see where it takes us. Lalu Prasad Yadav and the fodder scam. Lalu Prasad Yadav, former Chief Minister of Bihar, has been convicted in one of the cases of the fodder scam wherein Rs. 900 crores from the Bihar exchequer was siphoned off under the pretext of purchasing fodder for livestock during the 80s and 90s. Under the relevant sections of IPC and the Prevention of Corruption Act, he has been sentenced for 3.5 years of jail and a fine of Rs. 10 lakhs. If he does not pay this amount, he will have to serve another 6 months in jail. The Battle of Koregaon. There's a lot that has been happening in Maharashtra, a lot of violence, and most of it is related to this Battle of Koregaon. Let's see what this battle is all about. On January 1, 1818, a battle was fought between the British East India Company and Peshwa Bajirao II on the banks of the Bhima River, and thus came to be known as the Bhima Koregaon Battle. The Britishers won, and this battle has been celebrated every year for the last 200 years as a mark of Dalit victory, as Dalits had fought on the side of Britishers, and this was why the Britishers won the battle. The Dalits had occupied the lowest place in the Hindu caste system, and this victory is very special for them. Not many of us knew about this battle until Maharashtra was disturbed by violent protests against celebrating a British victory. So they are actually not celebrating a British victory, but they are celebrating the Dalit victory. Roads have been blocked and buses have been attacked, so a lot of violence going on there. The seventh is Reliance Jio reduces tariff plans by Rs. 50 on all its plans. The company is now offering data for as low as Rs. 4 per GB. Reliance Jio has slashed prices on all its mobile tariff plans by Rs. 50. The company is now offering data for as low as Rs. 4 per GB. Its cheapest plan, MRP 149, offers 1 GB data daily with free voice for 28 days, including free local and national calls. The plans will be available to customers from January 9. All the plans offer free local and national calls as well as free incoming and outgoing calls on roaming. The next news is Karni Sena refuses to relent on release of Padmavati and warns of consequences. Among the proposed modifications, Padmavati would drop the I and make it Padmavat, run a disclaimer that it is a work of fiction, and also clarify that the film does not in any way endorse the practice of sati. Despite these modifications, the Karni Sena has refused to relent on the release of Padmavati, issuing an open threat to filmmakers as well as the government. Sukhdev Singh Gogamedi, national president of the Rajput Karni Sena, said the Central Board of Film Certification and the BJP government will be solely responsible for the consequences that follow the release of the film. They are also demanding the resignation of Prasoon Joshi, who is the chairperson of CBFC. The ninth news is NASA. A hole in the Earth's ozone layer finally closing up because humans did something about it. The hole in the ozone layer was first discovered in the 1980s. This layer of the atmosphere protects the Earth from ultraviolet radiation, which can cause skin cancer and cataracts, suppress the immune systems, and harm plants. Just 2 years after the hole was discovered, the world jumped quickly to solve the problem. Several nations signed the Montreal Protocol, which would ultimately ban CFCs, the chemicals that were responsible for destroying the ozone. Fast forward decades later, and the ozone hole was measured at the smallest since 1988. The study, published in Geophysical Research Letters, reveals that a decline in ozone-depleting chemicals has resulted in 20% less depletion since 2005. The 10th and the most interesting news, don't miss the blue moon. The 31st of the first month of 2018 shall mark the occurrence of the blue moon that hasn't happened in the past 150 years. On the same day as the blue moon, viewers can also experience a lunar eclipse visible in the night sky. The moon is responsible for providing a rhythm to the tidal waves on the surface of the Earth, even when it is located at a distance of 385,000 kilometers from our planet. The estimated time for the event is during the middle of the night. Indian viewers can experience the blue moon as the moon rises from the sky. We hope that the rest of your week remains a productive and a good one. Do subscribe to the channel for important updates, as we will keep summarizing the week for you.